After a euphoric rise to power barely a year ago, the net satisfaction rating of President Aquino's administration has dropped significantly, according to the latest SWS survey. Is it too early in the game, and what does that say about government's performance? Later on in the show, we'll also talk to former LP senatorial candidate Neric Acosta, who is said to take over the DENR portfolio now that the one-year ban on appointing defeated candidates in the last elections is about to be lifted. Join us as we go behind the scenes of the political battlefields. I'm your host, Gigi Grande, sitting in for Pia Ontiveros. This is Strictly Politics. Joining us in this segment, Palace Communications Secretary Sonny Coloma and USC Political Science Professor Edmund Tayao. Good evening, sir.
Good evening, Gigi. Good evening, Edmund. Good evening.
My first question is to you, Secretary Coloma. When the last survey of the SWS came out, did the results still surprise you?
Not really, Gigi. No? We think there is some leveling of expectations. As you said in your intro, there was some sense of euphoria that greeted the new administration in June. Mm-hmm. And I suppose there is a point at which these expectations will have to be calibrated and measured against realities. We have been facing many concrete challenges in the recent months. Mm-hmm. And I think the leveling of expectations is just a fair result.
And what about the president? Did he take it as calmly as you're taking it?
The president has always been very serene and positive in terms of accepting opinion survey results. I observed this even when he was a candidate. If you recall, there was a point at which there was nearly a tie. Mm-hmm. But that did not faze him. Mm-hmm. And he felt that things were going to turn for the better. And he was quite confident that with better communication, with more effective campaigning, then he would be able to turn the tide. The same thing here, Gigi. He feels that we just need to do a better job of communicating with our people, and more importantly, we need to work harder so that we can deliver the goods.
He did say, I think it was last month, when he said that the dip in the ratings, there was another survey that came out last month, and he said that the dip in the ratings was in part due to the media not coming out with the good stories or the achievements of his administration. But do you feel responsible for that, being with the communications group?
Yes, we do feel responsible, and the comment of the president is based on experience. When he was a candidate, we realized that the opinion surveys were heavily influenced by news that was coming out of the mass media. Mm-hmm. And as he tells the members of the cabinet, the root word of news is new. Mm-hmm. People are always looking out for what is new. They want to know what's happening. They're interested in what their government can do for them. Mm-hmm. So it's natural that they will expect more from their government.
Now, this drop in the net satisfaction rating for the Aquino administration is a pretty big drop. It's an 18-point drop.
Yes.
Professor Ed, do you think the administration should be concerned about this?
Yes, very much. But I'd like to say that the political capital is still substantially there. Mm-hmm. And actually, I'm more concerned with the way the direction is taken by the administration. Mm-hmm. I hope that, so many commentators have started to label the president as a single issue president.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason for this obviously is because there are so many programs that either have not been appropriately communicated, or I hope really that there are some programs that have not yet been properly communicated. Mm-hmm. Or there are no programs to communicate at all.
Mm-hmm.
From the development work side, up to now, we're still waiting for the medium-term Philippine Development Plan.
Mm-hmm.
And, the disappointment of so many groups, for that matter, is one. Of all the presidents after former President Marcos, all the presidents had an empty PDP by the first 100 days. Mm-hmm. And, you know, of course, so many programs are dependent on the MTPDP because more or less it provides you a bird's eye view of how the administration sees the country at a particular period of time. Mm-hmm. So, sa tingin ko, this is one of the reasons probably why there's a drop in the net satisfaction ratings. But again, as I say, you know, the popularity of the president is unprecedented at the same time. Ito yung kwan dito, yung para sa akin, parang mystery, no? Sana hindi
Teflon.
That's right.
Parang nothing sticks.
That's right. hindi sana masayang because there are so many issues that are really to me landmark issues that have to be addressed. Mm-hmm. And mahirap yung isa-isa ka lang eh, no? So siguro yun yung tinitingnan. But look at Manila also. Na Manila, there's an increase in the support of the people.
Right.
So pwede mo din tingnan in the positive side.
You mentioned this political capital earlier. How long do you think or how far do you think that's going to take him?
You know, supposedly at this period in time, dapat wala na yan eh. So kaya nga sabi ko, to me it's a mystery because up to now, even if we say that there's an 18% drop, it's still a positive rating.
But no? Do you think that the numbers are falling too quickly?
No, not really.
So this is also something for you that is
That's
quite
right.
expected.
That's right. That's
okay.
right.
Now, Mar Rojas is supposed to be a presidential troubleshooter. Do you think that he should be troubleshooting this?
Well, as I mentioned off-cam to Secretary Coloma, to me, this is good news. No? The coming in of the joining of Senator Mar to the cabinet is positive.
Whether it's a troubleshooter or in an official capacity as official member of the cabinet.
That's right. Definitely. The administration needs all the thinking heads at the same time. Mm-hmm. You know? Of course, it's a question of how do you choreograph all these different talents together. Mm-hmm. You know, the Vice President Bina himself, of course, is to me an asset in the government. No, so how Senator Mar and Vice President Jojo Binay can work together, or at the very least concentrate on their assignments, would be a big plus to this government.
So, Secretary Coloma, when is that going to happen? When are we going to hear the official announcement about the new members of the cabinet?
Very soon, I imagine, because the president himself mentioned about the entry of Senator Rojas into the cabinet when he talked with reporters in Jakarta a few days ago. But if I may, Gigi, you know, Professor Tayao said that he was still looking for the medium-term Philippine Development Plan. Mm-hmm. Well, I'd like to let him know that the plan is about to be rolled out officially.
Yes.
We are calling it the Philippine Development Plan. And what's unique and significant is that it is about inclusive growth. You were saying earlier, Professor, no, na dati, sandali lang ay nabuo na kaagad yung plano nila. No? Mm. But the difference this time is we took the time so that we could consult as many people, as many of the civil society sectors, non-governmental organizations. And that is the reason why there was more time taken to flesh the plan in accordance with the 16-point social contract with the Filipino people of the president.
Let's go back to the announcement, though, with Senator Mar joining the cabinet officially. Are there any other announcements for any other cabinet positions that
I think it's
coming?
Best that we wait for the president.
No, but tomorrow, start the ban on appointment of losing officials officially ends today, and tomorrow there's going to be they can start appointing the losing candidates. What can we expect?
Well, that's true, Gigi, no? But as I said, let the president make the announcement. He's the appointing authority, and it's not for us to speculate at this point.
Now, we were talking about this earlier. There are two positions that are still up in the air, so
that's
to speak.
Right.
Two acting secretaries, still acting secretary Jesse Robredo of the DILG, and also acting DENR secretary Ramon Pahe. What are your thoughts on this?
Well, first, personally, I'd like to, if the president is watching, I hope that Secretary Jesse Robredo becomes no longer acting but a permanent position. There are so many from the development side the development organizations really see Secretary Jesse Robredo as an action man, no? Particularly mm-hmm. as far as that department is concerned. Mm-hmm. Well, on the part of the DENR, I think that has been one of the clearest declarations made by the government, no? Not necessarily the president himself, but many, I don't know if this is still a secret, former Congressman Neric Acosta really has been identified as the one identified for the DNR post.
Mm-hmm. It was promised to him.
That's right. Mm-hmm. So in other words, dun sa dalawang positions na yon, to me, it's the DNR really that is clear or a settled issue even before.
It's a little bit confusing, though, to me, Secretary Coloma, because over the weekend, the president made an announcement in Jakarta that there was going to be no cabinet revamp, that he was happy with everybody in his official family. But then we also have, these reports that, at least in the case of the NR, we're going to have a new secretary. So that, in a sense, that's a revamp, isn't it?
Well, I think we better leave it to the president.
We'll go back to the ratings. The ratings, do you think that the satisfaction rating would improve with a cabinet revamp?
I hope so, Gigi. The inclusion of Senator Mar for sure will add new ideas, or probably at the very least bring on the table new perspectives. Mm-hmm. And I suppose that there may be some other priorities that are ripe for public discussion. Mm-hmm. No, so I suppose that this can still be addressed.
You mentioned earlier that the president has been called having a single issue, like a single
That's
issue
right.
presidency. That single issue would be fighting graft and corruption.
For example, when we talk about CCT, when we talk about RH bill, for now, I don't know, from the academic perspective, I'm not sure whether we've seen all these different issues as forming one single the program of action as far as the government is concerned. Mm-hmm. Well, of course, I really smiled when about the good news of Secretary Coloma that the Philippine Development Plan is already waiting for its official rollout. Mm-hmm. Of course, there are different perspectives as to the timing of the and the reasons why the development plan has been delayed and so on. I wouldn't comment that anymore. The more important thing is that there is already this development plan, and the mm-hmm. question really is how to approach it, and what would be the different parts that will be put together, you know, by the administration working hand in hand with the both chambers of the legislature, you know, so that finally we can really address the more pressing issues.
Well, it would appear that the administration has made some advancements with some issues. I mean, the SWS survey does list down that in some areas the administration did get good marks in the area, for example, of reconciliation with the Muslim rebels as well as the communist rebels, right, Secretary?
That's true, Gigi, you know, and I think the survey also says that there are 5 items on which the administration scored a record high, and these are worth mentioning: setting a good example of morality, deciding quickly on important problems, the reconciliation aspect that you mm-hmm. talked about, mm-hmm. and acting according to what the people want.